Now we will see free body diagram. This free body diagram is an important concept in the engineering mechanics. What is that importance is to find the different forces that are acting on your body, to evaluate the forces acting on your body whenever it is in stationary motion, in a stationary state or in a motion state, we have to draw the free body diagram. And most of the bodies, or all of the bodies, are rigid bodies in engineering mechanics. We treat them like that. So to evaluate the forces and to find the resultant of the forces, we have to draw the free body diagram. This free body diagram is representing the body which is free from the support reactions or wall reactions like that. Suppose, see this, this is this is a simply supported beam, and this is simply supported beam is carrying certain loads like this. To evaluate the resultant of these two forces or how the beam is stationary, to find that we have to remove these supports, and these supports are replaced by their reactions. So the free body diagram of this beam, it is like this. So this is, these are the two support reactions. Say if these ends are A and B, then this is a reaction at A and this is a reaction at B, and say these are the two loads acting on it. So these supports are replaced by their reactions. Likewise, suppose if a spear, it is hanging from a wall with the help of a wire which is connected to its center, then its free body diagram is like this. Say this is the weight of the object and this is the force. We treat it as a tension. That force or tension in the string, and this is the reaction of the wall. Here the spear is pushing the wall, and hence the wall applies a force on the object or on the spear. So these are the different kinds of forces that are acting on the object. So these are called as free body diagrams. Whenever we have drawn the free body diagrams, then only we are able to find the or evaluate the forces. Here suppose we want to find the tension in the spring or tension in this steel string. To evaluate the tension, we have to find the different forces that are acting on the object. Here this is the diagram given. From this diagram we cannot find what are the causes or what are the forces that are acting on this object to be stationary. So by drawing this free body diagram only, we can find the different kinds of forces, that is the tension in the spring. So here the tension in the string, it is like this. Then by using the equations of equilibrium, by applying the equations of equilibrium for these free body diagrams, we can find the different forces, or we can evaluate the forces that are acting on the object. So along with this free body diagram, we should know the equations of equilibrium. What are these equations of equilibrium? It is sigma x is equal to 0, or you may call this as sigma fx, that is forces in the x direction, sigma fy equal to 0, and sigma movements. These are called as equations of equilibrium. The different forces acting in these different directions, x and y, and these are the moments. And we should maximum consider only two dimensional forces, forces acting in the x and y directions. So this is the process to draw a free body diagram, and these are the equations to evaluate the forces that are acting on the free body diagram. So while solving any problem in the engineering mechanics, First of all, we have to draw its a free body diagram. That means it represents the forces that are acting on the body by removing the different supports. So that is free body diagram. And now let me solve a simple problem by using this free body diagram. Suppose a sphere, it is placed in a V groove like this. This is a V groove, and a sphere whose weight is W is placed like this. And what are the reactions at the points of contacts? You are asked to find the reactions at the, suppose A and B are the points of contacts of the cylinder or sphere with the walls of the V groove. Then what are the values of the reactions at the points of contacts? So for that, first of all, you have to draw the free body diagram. So in this free body diagram, say this is the weight of the body and this is reaction at A and this is reaction at B. So all these forces, these are concurrent forces, they pass through the center of the sphere. To evaluate these reactions at the supports, we have to know what are the inclinations of these two edges. Suppose if this edge is inclined at an angle alpha with the horizontal, say if this is inclined at an angle beta with the horizontal, then these are the horizontal and vertical components of the inclined forces at the points of contacts A and B. So from this, say this is the angle of inclination alpha. From this reaction, it should be normal to the surface. For this surface, this reaction is normal. Normal means it is making 90 degrees. So here we are having a right angled triangle. Here this is alpha and this is 90, and automatically this is 90 minus alpha. So this horizontal angle is 90 minus alpha, and likewise this is 90 minus beta. So by knowing the inclinations of the inclined forces, we can find, suppose the forces, algebraic sum of the forces in x direction is 0. So from that, this is, say this is Ra. So this is Ra cos 90 minus alpha, and this is minus Rb cos 90 minus beta is equal to 0. So this is the algebraic sum of the forces. One is towards the right and another one is towards the left. So if one force is positive, and automatically the opposite force is negative. So right hand side I have taken it as positive, and the left hand side it is negative. Next, sigma Fy is equal to 0. So from this, these two forces are in the upward direction. This is Ra sin 90 minus alpha minus, not minus, it is plus, Rb sin 90 minus beta equal to 0. So by solving these two equations, we can find the two unknowns, so that is Ra and Rb. And here we are not using the moment of the forces. Why we are not using moment of the forces means, here we have to know only two unknowns and we are having two equations. By using only these two equations, we can find the two unknowns. So from this, what is this? This is Ra cos 90 minus alpha is sin alpha minus Rb sin beta is equal to 0, and this is Ra cos alpha plus Rb cos beta equal to 0. So by solving those two equations, we can simply find the reactions at the points of contacts of the sphere which is placed in the V groove. So this is the importance of the free body diagram. Without having this free body diagram, we are unable to find the reactions at the points of contact. Suppose this is the problem given, then how can we find the points, reactions at the points of contacts? To have that, the reactions at the points of contacts, they are taken as normal to this surface. Wherever the object is touching, then we have to write a reaction there which is normal to that surface. So by considering them, we are able to find the reactions. So like this, in engineering mechanics, for all kinds of problems, whether they are stationary state or motion state, we have to draw the free body diagram.